Hello everyone. This is your professor once again, Professor Danny Araneta Kabulay, for the course or subject Accountancy Research. We are now in video lecture number 32, and we're talking about research findings, how to present them when you write your manuscript. So for this particular video, we will discuss some pointers on how to present research findings, particularly if this would pertain to quantitative data. Yung may mga numbers, okay? So there are many ways to present your research findings, particularly if they are quantitative data. You can present them through bullets, or you can present them through tables, graphs, and dashboard. Let's look at each one of these one by one, okay? So, always refer to the PowerPoint presentation when watching this video. So, for the first example, let us look at how to present your data using bullets. Bullets are easy to read. Bullets capture our attention. And they're not so intimidating, and they're usually short, okay? Don't put them in bullets if they're long. So, better put them in paragraph form if they're quite long. But if they're short, better put them in bullets. They're easier to read. So, on the right side of the PowerPoint, you could see an example of how data on recruitment practices based on expert interviews with partners in charge of human resources in selected auditing firms is presented. For example, they're bulleted as follows: campus recruitment, online advertisements, job fair, and word of mouth referrals. That's an example of how you present your data gathered in bullet form, okay? So another type of presentation of data, quantitative data, is using tables. So tables are easy to read also, and you can easily compare the figures or the numbers when you can see them at a glance. So why do we use table? Because if there's a lot of numbers, it's very difficult to read or understand, comprehend the numbers if they're in paragraph form or bullets. So better put a table. Tabular form is the best way to present a lot of numbers, okay? So you have to cluster them, you have to classify them. A table is comprised of columns and rows. To illustrate, in a study on defaulting loans on selected branches of a particular bank, the collected data is presented in the table that is shown in your PowerPoint, okay? So loans in default, that's the first column. The first column is the branch. What are the branches? So what do we read in the branches? Guadalupe branch, Baclaran branch, Recto branch, Cubao branch, Ayala branch, McKinley branch, Shaw branch, Tomas Morato branch, Bicutan branch, and Salcedo branch. So the second column would pertain to the loans in default, so they are in peso values, in the millions. Then you have the loan portfolio of the bank or the branch in millions also, and the percentage of default. So it's very easy to see which of the branches has the highest and the lowest default percentage because they are arranged in tabular form. Okay, another way to show, for example, tabular form also, like for example, the next example would be about a factory. So we're trying to look at the average employee overtime work for September 2021. So the first column would be the different departments under the production division. So you have warehouse, cutting and molding, assembly, quality control, transportation, and you get the mean score, okay? So then the second column would talk about hours per week of overtime, and then other departments like accounting, human resources, sales and marketing, procurement, security, and then the hours per week would be the fourth column. So what can you notice easily here? Okay, anong mapapansin mo? So makikita natin na yung mga departments under production tend to spend higher overtime per week compared to the other departments. Diba? Mababa lang yung ibang departments. So at a glance, you can do your analysis already because it is arranged easily, no, in a tabular form. That is one of the advantages of a tabular form. Okay? Now, we have another example. So when we talk about the different branches or outlets of a particular coffee shop, let's say Starbucks, okay? Ano ba yung mga ways to analyze the findings, no? Kasi maaaring sila ay complied or maybe partly complied or not complied. So sila ay subjected to audit, operations audit. So the different branches of Starbucks in that particular area are audited, no? So yung tinatawag natin na, sometimes they call it management review or sometimes they call it quality audit, okay? So let's look at the table that was devised for this particular purpose. Ano ba yung mga outlets na iniimbestigahan o pinag-aaralan? Mall of Asia, SM by the Bay, Macapagal Boulevard, Asiana, Mall, Ayala Mall, Manila Bay. Okay? So, ba? Madami palang mga branches ng Starbucks dyan lang sa area na yan. Okay? So, there's the second column, complied column. How many have complied? What is their score? Okay? And then, partly complied. Okay? And then, not complied. And then, the score that they got. Okay? So, ano yung mga items na complied? Ano yung mga items that are partly complied? Ano yung mga items that are not complied at all? And then, the score of each branch. So, you will notice easily because it's in tabular form, you could easily detect that out of the 5 branches, 4 branches actually are compliant. So, generally compliant like Mall of Asia, SM by the Bay, Macapagal Boulevard, and Ayala Mall, Manila Bay. Only one branch appears to be not compliant, and that is the Asiana branch, okay? So why is it easy to find that out? Because it's in tabular form, see? So that's one of the advantages of putting your responses in a table. Now, the last example I'll give you is about a Japanese restaurant. Obvious ba na mahilig akong kumain? I love Japanese food, okay? Do you like Japanese food? I love sashimi and sushi, of course, no? Of course, I like also tempura. Now, let's look at the analysis or how the data was tabulated and then we can do the analysis, okay? How do we look at the performance of the different outlets, okay? So, 5 outlets of a particular brand of Japanese restaurant, chain of restaurants, is being analyzed. So, let's say, what's my favorite Japanese restaurant? Yayoi. Yayoi is my favorite Japanese restaurant. Casual dining, okay? 5 of its branches are subjected to audit, okay? And here's the performance. Only one was given a score of excellent. And then, 3 were given a score of very satisfactory. Only one got a rating of poor. So, that's 4 out of 5 passed the audit, okay? So, why do we know that easily? Because it's in the table. You could easily read from the table the results, okay? Then you can do your analysis, and your analysis will have to be in narrative form. Hindi po kinagawa kayo ng mga tables, that's it. No, the tables have to be explained. You have to articulate what's on the table and what is your analysis. What do you make out of that table? So hindi lang kayo basta maglalagay ng mga tables without an explanation, okay? So every table, remember this, should be explained in at least 1 or 2 paragraphs, okay? If there's so much to be explained in one table, go ahead. You can write 3 or more paragraphs if you wish, okay? So now, here is your item to be answered for like your quiz, okay? For video lecture number 32, this is your exercise. You need to answer this in the comment section, okay? So again, this is for collation and presentation exercise. From the previous example, which of these 4 choices has the best narration of the research findings? So you talk about the restaurant Yayoi, okay? Among the 5 selected branches of Yayoi, 1 was rated 100 or excellent, 3 were rated between 96 and 99 or very satisfactory, and only 1 was rated below 86 or poor. This simply means majority of the restaurant chain's outlets are performing well. Focus must be given to the only underperforming outlet. Huh? Now, what about B, your possible answer, letter B? Among the 5 selected branches of Yayoi, One was rated 100% or excellent. Three were rated between 96 and 99 or very satisfactory. And only one was rated below 86 or poor. Majority of the outlets are performing well. It is suggested that the least performing outlet be given proper intervention to improve its performance. Is that your choice? Okay, let's look at letter C and D, okay? The management of Yayoi chain of restaurants evaluated the performance of selected outlets. Majority of the outlets are performing well, with one as excellent, three are very satisfactory, and one as poor. This finding is expected as it was similar to last year's results. The team which garnered the highest rating should be the benchmark for the rest of the outlets. Is that your answer? What about D? Let's read letter D. Given the high standards of Yayoi chain of restaurants, having one outlet rated as poor, that is below 86, is not acceptable. Ideally, all evaluated outlets must be rated either excellent or very satisfactory. Any score or rating below is deemed not acceptable to top management. So which do you think is the best narration of that table? The best articulation or explanation? Is it A, B, C, or D? I want you to write the letter of your answer in the comment section below this YouTube video. Okay? So I'll see you around for video lecture number 33.